In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to do this. So this effect is what I believe is called the anamorphic effect, and it's actually quite popular these days. And it's basically based on projecting some sort of graphic within a space. So as you can see, these graphics are kind of hitting the various surfaces of the space, creating like a flat sort of illusion onto the space itself. So I've had a question last week from somebody trying to work out how to do this because they're working on a project that requires the creation of this effect specifically, and they wanted to find a way to create this and basically kind of give dimensions to whoever builds this to make it easier for them to build, as it's they're working with quite a complex graphic, and they found tutorials online, and apparently they can only find tutorials based on a very 2D graphic sort of projection mapping inside Cinema 4D. So I wanted to create this tutorial to kind of like answer this question, because I'm going to show you how to do this in a more physically based approach. So as you can see in my model, this effect is not created by 3D projection. It's actually physically cut into the space. And I'm going to show you how you can cut shapes into a space to create that effect. So this is based on a camera, which is located down here. As you can see, let me just unhide my cameras. There you go. So it's a camera. I've actually got two, but this is the one camera, and it's based on if somebody walks into, and it's like a, maybe a check-in area where you walk inside of it, and then you maybe go into the main space down here off to the right. I've used this brand called Represent, and Represent are basically a UK luxury apparel brand. So I've used their brand logo, which is down here. I basically traced the Represent logo, and here you have it as a 3D, as a 2D object. This is basically a vector logo that I've traced off Google, and I'm basically going to be using this logo and basically exporting that into Cinema 4D, and then using that to basically create my effect. So let's create this from scratch again. Let's go back into Cinema 4D, and let's go into a new file. I'm going to go to my top view, create a cube. Let's make it a 10 meters long by, let's say, 3 meters high and 3 meters wide. Okay, so I'm going to go into my, I'm going to convert into an object. See, move it up to the floor roughly. I'm going to go to my polygon selections and select a polygon, or delete it, select all my polygons, reverse my normals, so they're facing the right way. So here's my setup. I'm going to maybe create a, add a normal figure just for scale. I'm going to take it down a bit, so they're standing on the floor. Rotate them to face the space, 90 degrees. Okay, so here's my figure. I'm maybe going to extend the space so it's got more of a context around it, so it's not just an empty space. So let's create, let's go to my edges, loop selection. I'm going to deselect the bottom one for now. I'm going to go to just to an extrude like that. And I'm going to select the floor ones, select these edges on the floor. I'm going to press Control on my keyboard and then click and drag to extend my floor. So here you have a basic setup for the space. And I'm just going to add this opening at the end by going to my point mode, KJ, change this to a local setup, and YZ axis. I'm going to cut it down here. Select this polygon down here and just delete it. So now I have my basic setup. I'm now going to add the furniture inside the space. So I'm going to create a cube down here. I'm going to make it a meter long. Well, let's say 500 mil deep by 950 high by a meter long. I'm going to place it roughly on the floor. Like that. So that's going to be my check-in desk. And I'm also going to add a couple of more furniture on the floor. So I'm going to go down, rotate these around. I'm not being extremely accurate here. I'm just trying to show you, get to the effect we're trying to get to. So 450 for the height. That's my bench. That's one bench down here. I'm going to copy and paste it. And another one maybe further down along the space. Okay. So here's my setup. Right. And basically I'm going to use the logo of the brand, and I'm going to try and project this logo straight onto my space from this particular viewpoint. So I'm going to try and go into my character's viewpoint very roughly. So it's roughly down here. Okay, and I'm going to create a camera at this position. Right, and I'm going to move it back so I can see the whole space. Let's zero out its rotations and make it 90 degrees so it's nice and straight. I don't need the character now anymore. I'm going to move my camera backwards so you can see more of the context. Like that. So now I'm going to basically try and add the R so it faces this orientation, and then we're going to try and project it onto the space. So let's import the R from the brand and go to downloads. I'm going to import my logo, and here it is. As you can see, it's not facing the character yet, so I'm going to scale it up so it's big enough. And I'm just going to rotate it and move it into place. So here it is. So I'm going to try and work it from here now. So I want it to be inside the space. I don't want it to spill out because it's going to create more geometry for us. So let's just make sure it's within the space like that. That's quite good. Okay. And so now basically the idea is to project the space and cut into whatever is behind it. And for this to work, we need to increase the amount of geometry we have in our space. And we also, while projecting this line onto your geometry, we need to make sure that the geometry behind it is just one big object. So we don't do it on separate objects. We do it as one big object. So I'm just going to convert these objects into separate objects. I'm going to select all of them, including the space and the desk as well. So turn the desk into an object. Make sure it's on the floor. So select the desk and the benches and the space, and basically merge them all into one by going to connect object and delete. So now this is all one big object, which is what we want. And also for this effect to work, we need to increase the geometry of our objects, because as this line cuts into our geometry, it needs more data in order to know where these lines can be should be cut. So we're going to go to our polygon, select all the polygons in our object, right click, and then maybe subdivide a couple of times. So subdivide and subdivide. So now we have enough geometry, enough data for this line to know where the polygons need to be cut inside of it. So also we're trying to do the same thing with the line. So let's go to our line, our represent logo. And as you can see, for now, at the moment, we've only got a few points. We want to try and increase the amount of points so it also has some data to work with. So let's select all the points on the vector, and then let's also subdivide it a couple of times. So once, twice, so now we have enough points, enough data to work with our effect. So what we need to do now, in order to cut this into our geometry, we need to select the geometry, go to our line view, right? So we need to go into and select the object, go into your point mode, and then press KK for cut, right? This is our normal line cut. And for this to work, we need to press Control on our keyboard. So once you press Control and then hover over the logo, you're going to see highlighted in red. So if I hover over, you see the points highlighted in pink. And now that means that it's ready to work. So if I click on the logo now, boom, that's it. Now you can see I can hide my represent logo, and you can see it appear in our space, just like that. And so now if I come out of my camera, my effect is now cut into the space. So this is how you do this anamorphic effect into a space. And as the person who asked me this question last week was wondering, was that, well, now he can go, or he or she can go into the space and give accurate dimensions, because now this is all physical, it's cut into the space. So if you wanted to build this as a, you know, as a in reality, you could give accurate dimensions as to where these graphics need to be cut, right? So now that we've got the effects, we can just do whatever we want with it. We can select the polygons within the logo and then maybe turn them into a different color. So let's do that now. So let's go to our cube, let's go into our polygons and go back to our camera so we get an accurate representation. And we're going to go into the polygons that needed to be, that represent the logo. And you can see, you can even go over the furniture, over the separate objects, and literally select the polygons that we need for the logo. Like this. Deselect those ones. Select these ones as well. So any logo, any polygons that are within the R, I can literally select it and maybe disconnect it or split it into a different object and add a different color, a different material, and maybe do whatever I want basically with the logo. So I'm going to select these polygons inside the R. Just like that. I'm doing it roughly, but you can, you know, finesse it as you will. So let's just go like that. Okay. And now that I've got these polygons selected, I can go into my object and then split it, UP for split. I'm going to go back into this one, delete. And now I have my cube as a separate logo. And I can add a color to it. Let's add a corona, a black material. I'm going to apply it to my logo. Let's rename your logo, and let's rename that one space. And there you go, this is the space. I forgot a couple of polygons down here, so I'm gonna go into that space and select these two, UP, and maybe add that, those logos, those little polygons into the logo. There you go. Right, so that's it. So that's my effect. Right, and I've got my camera. And what I did earlier was I animated it. So this is the end. Let's go to the end frame, which is down here. Put a keyframe, go back to the beginning, maybe do a little rotation of the camera. Right, zero out the angles. Move it up a bit and add another keyframe. And from there to there you have it. This is the effect, anamorphic effect. And that, I've seen tutorials made for that effect, but they're all based on graphic applications rather than physical application. And I just wanted to find a way to do it. And this is the only other options I have come up with. And hopefully that will help you in creating this effect. And I also, as you can see, you know, I can go into there and I can just add, I can isolate it, and I can go to my measuring tool, right, and I can measure this and get some accurate dimensions for this. Okay, so I can just, 1.8. So I can just keep these sizes to, let's say, a production manager or someone responsible for building this effect, and it will make their lives a lot easier. And there you have it. This is the effect. And that's how you do it. And I hope you enjoy this tutorial, and give it a like and a comment, and let me know if you have any other comments regarding this effect. So cheers and see you later.